we got a little bit of Purge. How you doing, buddy?
Pretty good. How long did it, were you planning that? Like, we haven't said anything to each other in like 7 minutes. Yeah, it was a pretty long downtime between games, but it was a best of fives. These guys have to play a huge amount of games, and I don't even think they have team houses, so, you know, stuff comes up, patches, whatnot. A very different game this game, though, because no Kunkka for once. But there's the Kunkka alternative. It's Disruptor, and this is Disruptor and Kunkka have basically been the two heroes that have been absolutely dominating games in this whole tournament so far. I expect Kunkka at least to get pretty nerfed when the next patch comes up.
Yeah.
Pretty similar. I think he can get a lot done. In some ways, he looks similar to Shadow Demon. Do you see it?
I don't know, man. Disruptor is very weird. He was picked up a lot before TI6, and then at TI6, hardly that much at all.
But that's because Kunkka got back. That's because Kunkka does what Disruptor does, but arguably better, and earlier in the game as well.
Okay.
The ability to pull somebody back and get a disable afterwards, you get that by level 2 on Kunkka. Mentioned, yeah. X marks the spot lasts for 4 seconds with one skill point. So if you just get in melee range on somebody, you can attack them for 4 seconds until pulling them back. Like, there's so many strong things about Kunkka.
What's the problem?
Stronger, the cooldown's lower.
I'm not gonna argue with you, Purge. I think you're right. I mean, X marks the spot is I feel like X marks the spot is like Glimpse on crack. You know, you have so much more utility that you can do with that instead of Glimpse. But anyway, well, I've had enough about Disruptor. We've got the Mirana Oracle combo here. Very classic combo. Sacred Arrow, and then you put the Purifying Flames on. It's crazy, Purge. All the pros love it. Oracle. Good. Okay, why did they pick Oracle?
And whoever gets Glimpse back, Oracle can give him Fate's Edict, so they're magic resistant. Therefore, they don't take any damage during the Null Field or the Static Storm from Disruptor. One really good reason to do it. It also covers your potential Huskar pick. Kaipi does end up banning that, but for I think Oracle versus Kunkka especially is very good. I mean, Oracle was played prior to that even, but against those kind of combos, it's very effective.
Very good. So we see no Huskar. I don't think anybody's ever sad about that. And Sand King is out as well. Nothing too interesting. I think this next pick, Purge, this is going to tell us everything we want to know about this game. Vega Squadron, this is going to be a huge pick. Reveal their entire strategy. What are you thinking?
I'm not sure. Vega right now is very magic damage heavy. They're going to want to diversify a bit, but they could grab maybe one more nuker. Faceless Void's kind of a decent example. It's very magic damage heavy. I really like Time Dilation against the two heroes that Kaipi already has. You can prevent Shadow Demon from casting multiple Shadow Poisons. It's going to delay his disruption from coming off cooldown. I think that's one part of Faceless Void that isn't focused on enough or isn't thought about enough. They just think, oh, he's fairly okay as an offlaner. He's going to have Chronosphere, blah, blah, blah. But he's been a little underutilized. Maybe not underutilized, but he's not picked as much as he was in the last month. Very similar to what Oracle did. But Void Carry can work. Void Offlane can work. Maybe a dual lane. But I like the picks for Vega. It doesn't reveal too much. Gives them good team fight. Their damage is a bit diversified. Some good disables. I think it's a good opening that's going to force Kaipi to maybe reveal things earlier than they want to.
Oh boy. Nobody wants to reveal before they're ready, Purge. Kaipi. Tidehunter. They're going to go for the Tidehunter.
So they're basically just both teams counteracting each other in terms of the team fight. So nothing too interesting there. Although magic nukes are one way that Tide is a bit weak early game. So it can be a good pick. Void's also arguably good against Tidehunter just because you can kill him during Chrono and he definitely won't be able to Ravage unlike normally removing debuffs.
This is it. This is like a one, you know, when you're playing a pub and each one of your teammates go in one at a time. It's like a draft version of that. Like, oh, you're gonna pick him? Now I'm gonna pick you. Here you go. It's like,
are you saying they have good synergy? Is that what you're pointing?
No, I'm saying that they're just countering each other. That's it. I don't see the synergy at all.
Well, Elder Titan increases magic damage. Void does physical and magic. Oracle does magic. Mirana does a lot of magic. So Elder Titan in the game can be really effective, especially if you can do something like Chronosphere the front line and then Elder Titan stomp the back line while you throw out Earth Splitter. As soon as Elder Titan hits 6, you can rotate to Void's lane to do a Chronosphere Earth Splitter gank. I really like the draft of Vega. It fits together really nicely. I think Hypee has some potential here, but I don't quite see how the pieces fit just yet.
Oh, I see the pieces. Tiny gets an Ags, Shadow Demon disrupts him, and that's all the pieces you need. Everybody else is just getting them to that point.
That would make a lot more sense if Tiny Illusions actually had the grow bonus damage, but they don't. Do you want to try again, or...?
No, I don't want to try again. They don't have the damage?
I don't believe so. They do very, very little damage.
Holy shit, I hope you're wrong, and I just get to annihilate you. I'm going to look it up right now, Purge.
Dude, every single time that Tiny uses Manta... And there used to be a period of time where Tiny would always build Manta Ags. The illusions were worthless damage. They were just awful. The only reason you bought it was for the Moonsuit. That was a TC build. That was like TI 2 times, actually.
How is to build this happening? Manta X. Oh my god.
Just some things don't go over, you know? It's, I don't know, maybe it'd be too OP or something.
Okay. All right. Well, anyway, they sure do have a lot of girth here on Team Kaipe. Tidehunter and Tiny. Ooh, it's going to be pretty hard to get them down. And the damage output in the early game is going to be okay with Vega Squadron.
Did you double innuendo what? That on purpose?
I did. Nice. You like that?
Well played. I liked it. That was good. It was subtle enough. It was good. Really good.
Thank you.
Definitely a lot of beef on that side. The nice part is that they can just chase Vega down, and they have very low cooldown spells, partially countered, of course, again by time dilation. Very good against Tiny as well. He'd love to do more avalanche toss combos. But if they are chasing Vega, they can pull back using Glimpse. They can keep them from getting away with Shadow Demon. And there's always the threat of the Ravage as well. So Vega is going to be a little scared taking some fights, especially if Kaipe gets an advantage. It all comes down to the Chronosphere, though. That's one thing that lets them turn things around. Same with Elder Titan Stomp. So I actually like both teams' chances at the moment. It's pretty good, except for the fact that their Kaipe is actually very all-in on magic right now.
Yeah.
And Oracle does counter that if he uses his skills right.
Now, can you tell me why a Spectre ban? Spectre's not really a high-tier pick these days, and are they just really scared for the late game?
Well, Vega picked it. Was it Vega? No, I'm thinking... No, it was Vega. That was when Vega knocked Escape out of the tournament. They picked Spectre last, and it was a very, very solid pick at the time. Right now, they're just worried about the teamfight strength of Kaipe, and again, the chasing. What Spectre would do is give vision of everybody on Vega, so they could do, like, Haunt Glimpse, for example, if somebody got away. It would just be way too easy for them to punish and continuously chase Vega down. Oh, shit.
If you guys refresh the stream, I will give you a free Juggernaut set. Just press the refresh button. Don't worry about it, all right? You can trust me. All right, Slarky Malarky, he's picked up, baby. That's the damage that we were talking about.
It's
That's
a good Slark game, too, and it's somebody that can hit the backline with a Shadow Blade. So if he doesn't get Chronosphered, it's not a big deal. He just goes in the backline. He's going to aim for either Oracle or Elder Titan. He also has Pounce against Mirana. It's a fantastic pick this game. Spectre would have been a bit of a nuisance, and they have some ways to kill Slark, but I love the pick this game. If he can get a fast Shadow Blade, then it should open up even more options for Kaipe to take fights.
All right, all right. Well, who is going to come out here on Vega Squadron? Let's see. They got a lot of gusto.
More lockdown.
Oh my god! The illusions work, Purge, you
really?
Idiot!
Did somebody test it?
10 seconds remaining.
Eat shit!
Damn. Really? 5 seconds remaining. It's just because Tiny has never built good stat items.
Why don't you be the play-by-play caster this game, Purge?
I can do it better than you.
Oh, shit! All right, let's just bury this hatchet. We got a game to cast, and we got a Klinx. I mean, we're talking about last pick damage coming out from Slark. We are going full in on that Klinx. He's, to me, a very risky pick. You know, if he ever gets jumped on, he's done. But if not, he can do anything in the world. He could take towers. He could insta-kill the hardest of carries.
The way that I look at Klinx is he's a bad version of Slark right now. Like, his playstyle is get some items, use those items to go kill heroes, and then you transition into better and better teamfight items. But Slark scales far better just due to things of him being a melee hero, Echo Saber, much easier escapes. He's got like 3 different ways to escape. He can dark pack things. He can leap over trees. He can press his ultimate. He can press his Shadow Blade. What does Klinx do? He uses that built-in invis skill that your opponents are always going to predict, and
you know what?
Or he can get HP. That's all he does. He's killed when trapped.
But he's a ranged Slark, and they got a Faceless Void. You can't have Slark on the same team as a Faceless Void. He can't hit anybody.
Good point. So if they can get good Chronos, he's going to do huge damage. You're so smart. Yeah, this is a good thing we swap roles. Otherwise, there's no way you had time to say that because you would have been busy like making jokes in teamfights instead of talking about the Dota game.
Sorry. I did start those team fights by saying I'm not a good caster, so I am free from
I'm just
any...
doing this so I don't get fined. That's what it's going to mean. Disclaimer every time. I'm opening my mouth now, but it may be bad. All right, now I'll complete my sentence. Sorry for interrupting. It's basically what you're trying to do here.
No, it's all good. It's all good. You know, my favorite thing to look at.
That was a Mafia Land joke, actually. You get it? Sorry for
interrupting. Yeah, I got it.
Sorry for
interrupting. But anyway, check out, click on Sexy Bamboo in the middle. And I love looking at Shadow Demon with the paws. You get to see that beautiful head without any of the effects. Isn't that lovely?
It actually looks okay. And speaking of beautiful head without effects, you guys should check out Betway.com.
Hello.
Consider trying some money on the market. Make sure you're over 18, though. And this is a fully licensed site for a few countries. So if it isn't legal in your area, then you shouldn't do it. And if you're not over 18, you definitely should gamble responsibly. But if you do sign up using the links below the Twitch stream, you guys can get a free €5 deposit.
Whoa!
Betway.com.
5 euros.
Has
that's
nothing
like...
to do with non-burning skull heads, but.
Yeah, that is true. A pretty poor transition, but do. Hey, what are you gonna do? That's like $7. Pretty good.
Is it though? I think it's more like 5.8 or something. It's not that much.
Yeah. Who knows?
Times 5. It's like 6. Sorry?
Yeah, it's fine.
560? My God, Europeans have really fallen a long way.
Yep. Great job, Brexit. Well done. Anyway, so let's take a look at these lanes here. It looks like we're probably going to see a little fight here at the top. Maybe there are 3 of them there. I'm not going to speak in absolutes, but I don't know. A nice ward up top, though, Purgy. Look at that ward. It's got all the vision. They can see everything.
If you place it when you're smoked, it's very difficult for your opponents to anticipate it being there. It's much more common for that ward to exist after the 4-minute mark or so when people are sieging tier 1, so very difficult to deward. There's just so many good spots to place obs on that side of the map right now in Dota, so kind of gives maybe a bit of a dire advantage in the laning stage. But
yep. All right, well, no fight for the room most likely coming out here. As both teams will snag one, that means it's going to be an even fight, Purge. As we see Iceberg going to grab one. There we go. I got nothing else to cast. What am I supposed to
and
talk about?
Bambo grabbed the other one, interesting. Oh! I haven't seen him play SD in a long time, but he's a very good Shadow Demon. He gets shit done, and Shadow Demon's a fantastic hero for that. And the other hero on the team is Disruptor, being played by Pilot Eye. Normally, he does play the SD, so see what Bambo does. I think he's just going to spam Shadow Poison and try to get solo kills, but...
That's not a good idea. Isn't Shadow Poison poo-poo? I thought it was bad.
Well, see, normally you wouldn't realize this because you've probably never been able to land more than 5 shadow or 4 shadow poisons on the same hero, but that's really
that's
what changes
it. That's a disruption,
everything.
First level, as they're in the middle lane. Can we see a little bit of
they
coming
blocked
out here from
him in. Oh, they did it!
They got him!
They've been practicing! Oh, those bastards. Oh, that is abusive. That was basically
beautiful.
That was an 8-second stun that just happened.
Top lane, a little bit of action here as well. Standing 3-3 is gonna take some major damage. I mean, that's why you're gonna pick FNG on that Klinks. That early game damage is crazy. Now Perch,
did he have a fairy fire? I think he could have lived there.
Yeah, maybe. Sure.
So basically what they do is if you disrupt somebody, you can predict based on where the direction you cast it from and the way the hero's facing, where the illusions are going to spawn. And then if you position your hero perfectly, you can basically prevent them from moving. And because they already saw an arrow from Iceberg, Bambo gets arrowed.
Oh, what? Bambo, what an arrow and a stomp out. There you go.
He's salty. That happened because of how an arrow basically magically lifts. So it changes the camera perspective. So Bambo thought he was going to dodge that and he tried to get it really close because he knows he's a good player. Sometimes too good of a player.
Jesus.
Better than a player than he is, and he gets hit by the arrow, so definitely salty right now.
Uh-oh, Stomp coming out on Sinks, and here comes the arrow. What a save! What the hell? This is incredible! Wow! Sexy Bambo with the nice disruption there, and they're gonna try to put a little bit of damage, but man, this match is insane. It's a high MMR game, Purge. I can't keep up. These metas are too much
is.
For me. Whew!
Mag doing pretty well in the offlane. Normally Disruptor is okay at zoning, but it's tough this game. Other time died to a neutral.
Okay,
is that what this is about?
That's good, I like that.
Klinks versus Tide is kind of a good matchup too. In some ways that the Klinks pick is justified. I can't wait to see if FN plays well though. I mean, I'm just thinking about the last like 5 times Klinks has been drafted and almost always it just completely falls flat. So, but I have a lot of faith in FN as a carry. I really think he's a new standout player.
Sexy Bambo gets his double damage purged out by the
good
Fortune's
job.
End on Oracle. Uh-oh,
yeah, good move.
He's going to be grabbing him. I don't think this will be too much of a big damage here. Oh, but here is FNG with a beautiful stomp. There we go. And the gank never ends. Standing 3-3, trying to make his way up there. Not going to happen. And he is thrown back. Meanwhile, in the bottom lane, we see Mag is in some serious trouble here as he takes some major damage. His jumpy is on cooldown. The time walk. He's going to have to TP out. Sometimes, Purge, it's better to not kill and make them go home. Then they have to walk. Don't you agree?
That's almost as good as your slaughter analysis.
What? It's true. Close. It's... All right, anyway. Mid lane, not too much going on. We do see another neutral kill here. The neutrals are doing really well.
Something major is happening in the mid lane, and that's that Potom has way more last hits than Tiny does. And I know they've been having a little bit of action, fighting back and forth, but... Sing Sing should not be this far behind, especially because Tiny's base damage is quite high. Difficult against the kind of harass Amarana puts out, but especially he has to worry about Elder Tiny all the time like this.
There we go again, another stomp and an arrow connect, and look at that damage, that's the Oracle combo I was talking about. He's trying to make his way out here. Mr. Tidehunter coming in trying to help out Sing Sing in some major problems, and boom, that's an arrow to the face. 3-3, not able to do anything here. As another disruption comes out, though, they might be able to turn this around just a little bit. Iceberg does not have lead. 19 seconds. He is dunzo. Bunzo. Meanwhile, in the bottom lane as well, Sexy Bambo taking some major hits. Can he make it out? That Oracle damage early game. It's harsh, but it heals. He's fine.
It's actually more damage than usual due to the natural aura that FNG has already picked up. One of the things that makes it so cool, but nice plays by Kaipi there. The fact that they were able to actually get the bottom kill out of that was huge. They're always ready to rotate, and that's one of the biggest advantages that Kaipi has as a team. Very good at roaming aggressively, and very good at shutting down roam from enemy teams.
Yeah, very good stuff. All right, Cthulhu takes the bottle, and he moves back into the mid, handed off that bottle to Mr. Tiny. Not too much going on here, Purge. I feel like this match is a little bit too intense for me. It's too high MMR. I don't really understand half the things that are happening, but we're still doing great, Purge. I got you, buddy. That's all I need.
Well, you see, Slacks, the way Shadow Demon works is if you cast Shadow Poison 5 times, it does 16 times the damage that it would normally.
You lost me already. That's
multiply
too much,
that
man.
By the stack damage number that you can see on his icons.
No, that's
it's
too
just
much.
Pretty obvious.
Please stop.
Bambo right. Trying to stack Ancients with his Shadow Poison. That would have worked if it was a Dragon Camp, but it isn't a Dragon Camp, so...
Oh.
Smart for him to try the dual stack, though, because if he can accelerate that, it's going to give Tide a bigger advantage. So slightly unlucky that it wasn't Dragons, but I do like that when Shadow Demon players do this. They should do it more often. You can easily stack two camps almost every single time that the minute turns. So just accelerates all your carries.
God damn, my head hurts. I've learned so much about Shadow Demon in this game. It's too much. Anyway, down in the middle lane. Let's talk about items. What do we got, Purge?
Yeah, I don't want to talk about items. I like how Seamless Slayer was sapping experience from Tide delaying level 6.
Oh! Jet, Seamless Slayer coming in. Here we go, another damage and the arrow. That combo was just too easy, Purge. You get an arrow.
I would not want to ever be this tiny. Like, there's so many heroes I can easily gank him, and there's always going to be the arrow follow-up. The only solution is really if Bambo's constantly sitting behind him, so maybe he can criticize Bambo for that. Bambo instead going to the top lane to grab levels and experience, and he had to actually use his TP about 30 seconds before. So I'm sure Sing Sing's a bit frustrated, but he could also perhaps try to focus more on stacking, but Tiny's just not good at that.
Yeah, it's not looking very good, buddy. I mean, how do they fix that situation, though?
It's pretty straightforward. The best way to come back after losing is to get kills, and Tiny is one of the best mids in the whole game to do that. Especially because Potom's HP is not that high, so... If they can transition this later, sometimes eventually still get a blink or have some good fights, it can do a lot.
I see. All right, top lane, we're looking like a fight might be breaking out. The boys are kind of in position, but they're going to back out for now. Take their time. And the Faceless Void, he's not doing too bad in this bottom lane, Purge.
Yeah, they've only had one support there, so it's pretty hard to keep him completely out of lane. Disruptor's perfect against it, does damage over time, can't pull him back from the time walk, but... With a Slark, it's just not enough. Poor Man's Shield just pretty much counters all of the damage that they're doing in the early game.
Yep, there we go. Well, beautiful stuff coming out there. Now, oh no! Tiny, don't you do this again, please. That's report territory if you die to that combo again. Alright, he's out. Thank God.
Well, Shadow Demon's here as well, so... Be fine, probably. Rotation for FNG to the bot lane.
Highlight die. Ooh, could we see something here coming out? Pi is gonna go 1v1 on this guy. Oh, no way, going to sleep tonight? I'm staying up! Pylai died, turning this fight around on FNG. FNG has got to get out here. Here comes Faceless Void. Does he have level 6? He does! And he barely picks him! Sexy Bambo getting not so sexy after that black guy he's gonna receive there. Can we see another arrow? Boom! We will! And Pylai is a die. That's a two. Man, this is a much different match than last time, Purge. Vega is kicking some dicks.
Great D wards here. They're gonna be able to grab the obs on the enemy team. I think. Yeah, they've got it for sure, and the obs. Although Pylai Dai being in that position, he did see the Elder Titan place the Observer Ward in the jungle, so they're kind of trading even on vision here, and Vega's definitely getting the better of this early engagement, but maybe they can start doing some smoke ganks. The big number, I think, is Tide Ravage, whatever items he gets, and of course Disruptor Ult. Once they get those levels, they can actually start fighting and taking easy kills. But until then, they're definitely having trouble. Shadow Demon just doesn't have the same impact that Kunkka has for Bambo, so I feel like he's falling flat a bit here. And now FN's rotating for ganks, like, things are getting scary.
He's getting pretty spooky with that Klinks. He does have that power treads complete, so this should be a pretty easy kill if he decides
Just hits Arcane. Won't kill him, I don't think. It's gonna be close. One needs one more.
Buddy! Gets it. Yo, there's the weasel.
Really well done. Oh, you get stunned up.
You want to fight? I'll fight you, says Tiny. Here we go. The battle is on as the rock is being thrown on the Skellyman. He's out of there. Don't worry about it. Skellyman out. Meanwhile, in the top lane, here we go. Low initiation here on Elder Titan FNG. The shoe is on the other foot as he tries to stop. He will get it off, but it will cost him his life here. Pylai Dive probably going to go down to... What a disruption! He says no! And it goes to another dimension for a couple seconds. He's good.
You think it's nice there? Like, what if it's just like a vacation or something? You're like, wait,
I
want to...
I don't think it's nice. You look at the Shadow Demon. He doesn't look like a guy who's going
to... What if he's just like a really nice guy and he just wants to give you some like vacation time? Because it's like a timeshare or something. He doesn't use it and he feels bad because he pays like $2,000 a month or something. He's like, please use my timeshare. Nobody else's.
That does make sense. I mean, he is evil and only evil people do buy timeshares. So it makes sense to me. Let's be real. Sorry, timeshare people.
Yeah, just flamed all of the timeshare employees that happen to be watching.
They're not gonna like
that. That was a joke.
That was not a joke. Fuck
you, timeshare
people. Probably
found it in reality,
but... Okay, here we go. Anywho, talk about some stuff here. I'm gonna do some analysis. You ready for this?
Okay. Is it about Slardar? There's no Slardar, so...
There's no Slardar this game. Here's some my analysis here. Bone 7 gonna die. He's asleep. He's under the tower, though. He's okay. Just kidding.
Elder Titan doesn't have 6. Lynx doesn't have an Orchid. How does he die there?
Okay. Well, he went to
fired.
Sleep.
You're actually
okay.
Fired.
I'm sorry. I didn't know he'd get the leap off. You don't have to jump my shit about this.
Okay.
Alright, anyway, bottom lane. Here we go. Mag
could chrono, but there's nobody here to follow up is the problem.
Uh-oh, Purge. Don't talk too quick, because here comes FNG. This is the perfect thing.
Literally the perfect hero for this, yeah.
Yeah, this is
it. Positioning is pretty good, though. They're anticipating this Klinks rotation. They have a sentry in the area. And was trying to bait this out. Oh, he hit 6 just now.
Oh, shit. They're out of there.
They see Klinks. They see him.
Oh, no. This is not going to be good. Oh. And he's going to go in, but instantly disrupted. Here's that combo I was talking about. That's why you pick a Klinks and a Void. One of the only heroes that can deal that massive damage. And there you go. Bye. But,
okay,
man.
20% chance to stun there. That would have been insane.
Pretty sick.
Problem is that Pylai Dai was a little too focused on going on the Void, and that was the same time that the rest of his allies spotted Klinks being there, so the whole fight got messed up. Really good disruption on the Void, at least it buys them timeshare, but... and at least delays the death, but if they would have been able to at least ulti first, it would have been fine. But it just didn't have the setup. It got a little too complicated.
That is a pretty quick Shadow Blade on a Slarky Malarkey, if I say so myself. 11 minutes, yeah. Shadow Blade coming out. He's going to be ready to party, but he's late. Place has already been to the party. He's already talked to all the girls. I mean, he's been... The beers are gone, the kegs are empty. He's going to have a rough time at this party.
He did skip treads, though, so his attack speed's a bit lower than normal. But the big thing is him getting kills. I really do like the choice to get Shadowblade before Treads. He needs to get online faster because he knows that Vega's already ready. Chronosphering and getting kills this whole game.
But
even Klinks has been getting good kills. What?
Counterpoint. If he doesn't get those kills and he went Shadowblade first, he's worthless. He can't do anything.
That's not true. He can still... I don't know. He can get kills for this. Gonna try here. He's not gonna be able to kill Oracle, but
yep, Oracle actually gonna be able to turn this around on him a little bit. There comes the purge quickly and perfectly, but they
oh, this could be bad. No, he doesn't have leap
this.
For 5.
There we go. Watch out! But Faceless Void, he's in. They got the time dilation.
Leap.
Oh, I don't want to say I'm right, but I was right.
All right. The only reason you're right is because all of Vega's heroes were there, and he even bothered to attack Seema. He knew he wasn't going to kill him. Like, Seema just could have ultied himself, or casted his second skill, immediately upon getting pounced, and he just would have lived no matter what. Like, there was actually no way that Bone 7 gets that kill, unless Seema's just not watching his hero. And there was a high chance that his opponents were in that area. Now, he did have a ward there, so he thought that Seema might be alone, but everybody on Vega was in the general area. Meg just farming the jungle aggressively due to the tier 1 tower being dead. I mean, there's some of these things could have been predicted, but Kaipi's kind of dropping the ball right now this game.
How much you want to bet?
Anything new for Tiny? Is that Blink?
Nope. Is that Blink?
Okay, he's got Blink.
Okay, this
time
to
play the
start.
Game.
This is new. Okay. You can't give Tiny any room, man. Once he gets that Blink in the early game, that is a massive amount of damage coming out. So, scary stuff here.
This is an Arcane Rune, too, by the way. So,
oh,
if they
shit.
Can fight with this, he can do combos so much more rapidly.
All right. I hope you've been on Betway right now, because put your bets in. It's about to go down. Here we go. Middle lane. The defense comes. The smoke is on. Will we be able to get a pick here on our jungle iceberg Murata?
Oh, this
should
is
be
perfect.
Pretty easy. Oh! Take me. Didn't even get to know. She didn't even know she was going to die, Purge. It came so suddenly.
They didn't even pounce that. They just knew it was killing. Here's a follow-up.
Oh, God. Here we go. FNG taking a little bit of damage. He is going to be brought back, though, and the throw, the slam, and the jam. He's out of there. Most likely, take a little vacation. See the timeshare before you die.
Oh, the toss back on Seema.
Oh, could it happen? And well, and they're going to go straight on top of Seema the Slayer as well, taking some massive damage under the tower. It is the beefiness of these heroes to be able to tower dive like this so early in the game purge. And there we go.
And Sing Sing's mana is still full. Every single cast was 72 mana instead of the typical 120. So they do all of that fighting, they kill all of those heroes, and they're going to get a tower from it.
Beautiful. But
they're still ready. They didn't even ravage. Like, they're so far ahead.
Okay, don't worry. It's kind coming, Purge. Coming.
They're playing from behind, though. But that fight, that was like the best timing I've ever seen for a team that was pretty stagnant for the last 10 minutes.
Pretty stagnant, indeed.
Way too much snacking. That's the problem.
Snacking?
Snacknet.
Snacknet? That word?
Snacking at the Dimensions vacation house.
You're really still on this, aren't you? Listen,
I'm all in. Play Shadow Demon. I know what he's actually saying, dude. It's obvious.
Alright.
Like, please don't throw up on my couch.
You're still all in on this.
Please wash the sheets after you're done with it.
We're going to see another smoke coming out here from Team Vega. They're looking to make sure that this little bit of glimmer of hope is going to be extinguished from Kai P as they look around. And maybe they're going to go straight into Roche. They're going to check it out. I think they got the damage for this, especially with FN on that beautiful Klinks, who does have a Desolator completed. So, oh no! Counter-initiation, though, from Kai P. This could be a complete nightmare. Don't stun him, Roche! Stun him, Roche! Kill him! It'll be hilarious. Oh, no. Too bad.
Got enough HP where they know they don't have to kill it instantly, and they deward the obs on the high ground, so they have much better vision control here. It's going to force Vega back for sure. And FNG also doesn't have his Earth Splitter yet. I'm a little unsure about this choice. I kind of like having more Natural Order, because it's going to enhance Klinks' damage and the other magic, but he's got a Chronosphere. He's got a guaranteed way to land this skill.
I mean, but do they really want to fight? If you get that Chronosphere off and you don't get pretty much the whole team, and they have so many ways to make sure that nothing's going to happen there, Purge.
Dude, they could just disrupt somebody. They could blink, ravage the backlane. Do they have blink? Actually, don't. No blink yet on Tidehunter. That's one weakness. So if they can Chronosphere Tide and kill him during that combo, then they can absolutely win the fight, but that's a difficult. That's the end of the game.
Uh-oh. Everyone's pretty spread out here. If they go in, it's going to be a disaster. Here we go. Iceberg in some major trouble. There goes our first ravage of the game, and Iceberg is looking not so good.
Oh,
the counter chrono initiation. Here we go with FMG. The damage, the power of that little Klinks. He don't give a hoot. And here we go. Can we softly get Sexy Bambo? The chase is on. They're trying to find him. Arrow goes out. Not going to be hitting anything, but wait a second. Could we see another initiation here?
No, Bash.
Get him, baby. Unlucky. Run. Run. Sell your timeshare before it's too late. No.
Oh.
He's out. That damage.
So much
from
damage.
Klinks. My God.
Fight looks so good for Kaipi there. They initiated properly. Boom. They threw two heroes in. Just didn't work. Do we have a replay for that one?
Ooh. Yeah, you might want to hold off on that, because here we go. FNG still on the hunt. I mean, the massive amount of damage that this guy does. If he gets a single stun, whoop! Got an invisible Slarky Malarkey. He's moving in, just like Dark Grief Prison. Will he be able to find his way out? He's got the mana, he's got the stun, and he's got the fun. Here comes the Tidehunter throw down! No! The arrow is going to be able to stop him a little bit. Here comes... Oh, show me the damage! He's
okay.
Out of there. Thank God. Uh-oh, they're actually going to get some more out of this, Purgy. This is
okay,
not looking too good.
Boss kind of hurting things slightly, but killing the Klinks is a huge initiation there for them.
Yep.
Pace is just so strong. How can you play against Blink Dagger with Toss? The amount of utility that you get out of it is they've got Pounce. They just have so many things that force Vega to continue the fight. Those Chronosphere fights that Vega had are perfect, but expecting on them to happen every fight is not likely.
Absolutely. And Klinks has to be in the perfect position for those. If he's not, yeah. Hurts. It ain't good.
I mean, he has been very effective. He's 6-1 and 2 right now. That was his first death. But they expected to be able to take the tower. Take the 2-2, and let's jump to a replay.
Illusion!
Especially with Klinks on the outside of that, it just makes a huge difference. Like, one or two heroes die right away. Tiny is actually quite weak to Klinks with Adesso.
Sorry to interrupt.
He's got to be careful.
We might be seeing a little bit of action here in the bottom lane. Oh, no, we got time.
What are you talking about, dude? They're grouping,
what?
But like...
They're grouping! I thought it could happen. I mean, he ran in there very aggressively. You could see it in his little face. He had fire in his eyes. Because he's Klinks.
Does he? I thought it was like fire in his chest.
Okay, thank you, Purge.
Were you there when we figured out the lore that Klinks looks like a Smeeble?
Yeah!
That right? That was
check
you and
this
me.
Out, Pimpmunkle. We figured out that he's a freaking dead Smeeble. Look at the Smeeble courier, Klinks. He's got the same horns. He's got everything, dude. And the... Check
and,
this out,
and,
too.
Yeah,
his
go ahead.
Chest,
you got this.
His chest is the Aegis of Immortality, which is what a Smeeble stole from the shopkeeper to become Roshan, dude.
Yeah, so now
it's
look at Klinks.
Schmeeble.
Look at Klinks and Roshan. They have the same horns.
They're the same, dude. They're all Smeebles, bro.
Yeah, anyway, next level. When Smeebles came out, I'm like, okay, they just created this weird little thing. Like, that's cool, I guess.
No, dude.
But it's all intertwined.
It's all in the lore, bro. You had no idea.
let me look
welcome.
At his skeleton too. Yeah, I mean, he kind of looks like a person, but.
No, dude. He's got a sad story, Klinks. You know, he used to be a good guy. He's trying to fight this fire demon, and he got promised immortal life if he killed a demon. Then, when the arrow struck the demon, killing him, he was set on fire by the demon, the spell activated, and he has immortal life, but he's constantly in anguish on fire because of it. That's a shitty card, Purge.
Are you supposed to focus on last hitting when you're on fire all the time, dude? That would just...
I don't know. Pain makes me focus a lot. That's how... Yeah, that's my career. I'm in constant emotional pain.
You got that from just being alive, though.
The pain of life.
Not necessarily cast.
That's all. Hey, let's talk about some items here, eh? You love talking about items
that's
first.
That's always what you go to. BKB on the way for Klinks. Not quite there. It needs about 1,000 gold. Blink on bottom's pretty huge. At least that way you can initiate, throw some nukes, and get out. Hopefully before Glimpse follows up. So very needed. He'll have to go BKB probably after this because there's usually this time period where bottoms are constantly punished by heroes like Disruptor.
What's Slarky Malarky getting next? I see an Oblivion Staff.
See the typical Echo Saber build that he's been going for about 8 months straight.
Okay. Is that good? What does Echo Saber do?
You get 2 Essence Shift hits, and it also applies a slow to guarantee that your pounce lands. It's all around a really great choice, and more mana regen, because in some elongated fights, Slark will run out of mana, so great out of build.
Wowee, look at that. Echo Saber on Slark, who would have thought? I'm just joshing you. Everybody would have thought. It's standard stuff. Anywho.
Yeah, I'm not even sure if you're messing with me right now.
I'm definitely messing with you.
Oh, okay.
Definitely messing. You're fine. Yeah, but literally nothing is happening. I'm a little depressed.
What about the farming? What about the movement? The teams playing it safe? Pilot die baiting down here? You see this?
I'm a support. None of this means anything to me. I don't farm. I don't understand it. Doesn't matter to me. I'm all about the action, Purge. I'm about the murder. This is WCA. This ain't the join Dota qualifiers. I don't even know what that is. I want the death, buddy.
Trying. The creeps are dying. They got that.
As my dad always said, trying is the first step to failing. Here we go.
That's true. No wonder you're unhappy. Okay.
Second place is only best loser. Alright. Bottom lane going down. They're going to let that tower go. Not even a fort. Not even a fort on that tower.
Well, yeah, I mean, they should have forted it. Make him waste 8 seconds or whatever, but they weren't going to defend that. They don't feel comfortable fighting right now. There's just too many scary things on Kaipi. Blink Ravage on Tide. Blink Tiny. Like I said before, they just keep fighting. They can keep their opponents in the area. Vega's got to get some crucial things, and one of which was the BKB on Klinks. Because if he jumps in the fight, and there's a Chrono on a couple core heroes, and he starts slapping away at him with his burning arrows, then Tide just blinks past the Chrono and ravages him, then the whole fight space lost, because you lose about 2 seconds of right-click time. But if he can guarantee that somebody dies in the Chronosphere using BKB and his right-clicks, the whole fight's changed, especially if it's a crucial hero like Slark or Tiny.
Yeah. Alright, Perch, I'm not a genius, but I'm starting to get upset. Shouldn't Vega be pushing fights? I mean, they're just letting Slark farm up? He's just getting items,
so
he's just
basically what I just said is the reason that they weren't quite ready to fight. Now I think they should fight, yes?
Yeah, that's what I'm saying.
You got BKB, but before that point, not necessarily.
Okay, here we go. FNG gonna be caught out right here, and that is such a great pick. I mean, he controls all the team fights. They are ready to go absolutely bananas right now, buddy. We're gonna see an Invis coming out from Mirana. They're hoping that they're gonna walk right into these wards and get in the right position, but no. Team Vega, they're gonna miss out on that team fight. Kai P too smart for that. They've been in these woods before, and they're spooky woods. I ain't Goldilocks. I'm fucking out of here.
What does that have to do with the three bears?
You know, because they get the hot porridge and then they peace. They're not Goldilocks. Going to stay there too long.
So in this analogy, what is the hot porridge?
The hot porridge was the kill, and Goldilocks stood around too long. She got caught by the bears. And Kai P's out of there. They're not Goldilocks.
All right.
Keep up with the lore, Purge. Here we go. TP's coming in on the top lane. Nice Chronos Bear. And there we go. Instant amount of damage coming out. Look at that explosion. Holy shit. Iceberg is just going ham. There we go with a counter initiation on the rabbit. Sing Sing does not have that much mana. He's going to instantly go down. And they're going to try to find as much as they can here from Bone 7. Bone, does he have enough with the ding ding? Here we go. Boom. He's going to be out of there. Can we see something coming out from Mag? He does have a Blink Dagger. He's going to be just fine, even if they found him.
That was a not good fight from Kaipi there. The Ravage was late, and Iceberg was able to TP home despite getting caught right at the start of the fight. He just popped his ult or something like that, and then he TP'd, and he got out just in time. No stuns.
Uh-oh, double Blink. Look at that great Blink. That was very good, but 3-3. Kept the vision very well, but doesn't really matter.
Synchronized swimmers?
Yeah, that was great, Purge. You're really doing it.
Hey, thank you. I'm new to this. This analogy thing with children's themes.
Analogies. Yeah, children's.
Best analogies.
It's the best way to get a child to follow you is using analogies.
Is this how you get subscribers? These kind
of
strategies?
Dude. Damn. Oh. I was more of a... I like the direction you took that. That was more of a joke about kidnapping children. So thank you for taking it to a different direction than where I was in. So what do we got here? Purge, talk to me about items. I know you love talking
Four staff. Got me again. Four staff on Shadow Demon. The goal for SD now is that he can sit so far back that he doesn't get caught in Chronospheres. He wants to be there to catch allies or defend allies if they do get caught, but you run into this problem where Boyd jumps for the back lane anyways, assumes there's heroes there, and if you get caught in that, you die instantly. That's one of the problems for Kaipi in that last.
Hey, I got a problem for Kaipi. We got a double smoke. Here we go. It's a Snoop Dogg video. They both reveal, but one of them's on the high ground. Holy shit, Mac.
He doesn't have Chrono. Why would he go in?
What is he doing?
What's
he's
the glitch?
What is happening? This is so confusing. FNG putting on the damage. That's one hero I can understand as they go straight on Bone 7. Bone 7 gonna pop his ultimate and try to do what he can, and FN is just putting on that damage. There we go. FN with the only kills that we're seeing. Standing is gonna TP away and taunt at the same time. Pretty hilarious stuff. But, what was that, Purge?
I mean, both teams didn't have their big teamfight ultimates. No Ravage, and there was also no Chronosphere. So, Mag made a pretty crazy mistake jumping in like that. He did land Time Dilation on four heroes, which in some ways won them the fight. But the last second glimpse there by Disruptor pulled him all the way to the back. He was probably hoping that he would stay within the static field, but that wasn't the case. Kept Mag alive, and then Vega is able to eke out a couple kills on those supports. The BKB for FN is really paying off.
Whew.
And that's been the difference. He's gotten kills, but he hasn't died very much. It's like one of the only ways to make Klinks effective. Behind, he has a lot of trouble compared to most carries. But he's doing a good job this game.
He is doing a very good job. I mean, they're using him very effectively. They're not really making him get pickoffs. They're just using him as their main damage dealer in the Chronos or in teamfights. He's doing very well. And he picks up an Aegis. That's lore. That's good for the lore.
It really is. And the other problem is that Slark normally does magic damage at this stage primarily, so he's not good at dealing with Klinks, who buys a BKB at this stage. So Slark, while good against the supports, is now having a lot of trouble getting kills. And he's also forced to go a weird item build. He's got a plate mail now, but he has to do this because of the build of Elder Titan with the passive removing his armor based on his base stats. So needs some raw armor so that he can actually fight more, especially against Klinks on top of that. It's actually kind of cool synergy from Vega this game.
It really is. And Kaipi is in such a bad position here because they don't even technically need to win team fights with Klinks doing this much damage and a Desolator. These towers are going to melt. So as long as they get one pick, like for instance, if he died Tidehunter to the Chronosphere, I mean, they're in just a huge amount of problems right here.
Pretty greedy for them to farm in that location, actually. But how did they even know? Oh, they have the ward over there on the right. He placed it and then they realized.
Damn.
Kill, no Ravage for 37. It's clear they have plenty of damage to deal with the Tidehunter. That was mostly magic damage picking him off. The aura from Elder Titan. So yeah, Kaipi's kind of on the back foot. Vegas really controlling the game now, though. The last couple fights have in some ways been Kaipi teamfight throws, but Vegas is playing more aggressive in the way that they need to.
FN just taking these towers so easily with his Deso. They don't need to fight, but they can if they want to. Sing Sing a little bit. Oh, barely making it out of there. Great blink by Sing. And yeah, I mean, it's the noose is tightening for Team Kaipi. Purge, how do they come back in this game?
Group and take fights. That's the thing. They've got to win fights, and they can. They've got Ravage, they have Tiny, they have Disruptor. Just they have to get maximum value out of their skills. They have to use them in the right way, and they have to go in first. Once they do that, they'll be fine. But it's going to be hard to take these fights. There's Invis heroes on the enemy team. Got a gem as well, so most of the wards for Kaipi are being destroyed. Makes it hard for them to get that engagement. They have to worry about getting smoking under wards, walking into Klinks, who runs the opposite way and pops BKB.
Yep.
Daedalus now on Klinks as well. He's insanely farmed. Great damage.
Oh god, that is going to be absolutely disgusting, the next Chronosphere that comes out. They've got to be super careful. What do you do? What do you do? Chronosphere comes out, half your team's going to die, dude.
He'll face his Void first. I actually think the Slark maybe made a small mistake there. Should have followed the Void. They could have possibly glimpsed him back. I think they were scared that the whole Vega team was behind him, though.
I don't know. I don't want to sound like a defeatist, but these guys are screwed.
I don't want to sound like I'm calling the game before it's over, but this game's over. There's a BKB on Mag as well. He hasn't died yet. The BKB is going to guarantee his Chrono off. No Ravage bombs.
Oh, whoa! FNG taking some major damage. Go to sleep, Slarky Malarkey. Doesn't matter, though. He's just going to pop it up. Run into an arrow! Oh, my God! Can they do anything with this, though? Sixing is going to put out some major damage. Here comes the Ravage. But the Chrono doing so much, Moonset. What is a disruption? Oh, God! He's so
keep him alive.
Disruption. There we go. I thought he was going to die. He saved his life. Now Slark is able to turn around on Mag. Mag going to jump out of that. And FN, a triple kill. I mean, if he could catch anybody at this stage of the game with this amount of damage, they are dead, Purge.
Yeah, it's out of control, man. If he just does way too much. The minus armor from Desolator plus the Elder Titan. He got through this hard phase of the game where you hit about mid-game. Everybody buys a few armor items. But the Elder Titan plus the Deso plus the low deaths on FN are actually making Klinks look valuable. And he would be played more, but I feel like most players just can't stay away from those mistakes the way that FN can as a player. So he's really showing the value of Klinks in this.
Oh, he definitely has to kill himself soon, though. This Aegis is going to go out, so he's got to make some pretty crazy plays that could win this game here if he wants to. Come on, FN, go crazy, go ham!
Oh, really cool. Really cool by Steema. I think he soft-purged the glimpse. I promised you guys that I would never say that again on a broadcast, but...
Oh, please.
But
oh,
it did purge
God.
Off the glimpse.
I want to say something so bad, I'm going to let it go. I'm going to let it go.
It looks like it does remove Glimpse. I wasn't sure about that. Kind of a nice counter. With that said, it should also work on maybe first nerf to Kunkka that could be done.
Take some deep breaths. I'm going to hold it together. Yeah.
It would be better if I said hard purge or...
Just let it go. Anyway, so... Tell me about items purge. I mean, do we have any... Sorry. All right, smoke coming out here on the top.
Come on, that joke is definitely gone. It's not even funny.
Come on, one more. Okay.
Silver Edge is what Slark's picking up. He still has the casual plate mail, completely worth it. Can break the passive for Elder Titan. That'd be pretty good.
Oh.
Two ships passing the night, except one of them knows that the other ship is there.
Oh, show me an arrow. No. Close, though. They could be able to get him, though. Sing Sing is a little bit go to sleep. Not going to happen. There's the Chrono, and that is going to cost them so much. Without that, I mean, they're going to be able to force a buyback. They're taking a tower. Not good, buddy.
It's not time for Rex yet. There's still tier 2s that they have to kill, but a little unfortunate for them.
There's
they
only
to use
one.
Chronosphere, but...
They got this. They're going to at least force a buyback, right, Purge?
Maybe.
Maybe
they
my ass.
It, I guess. They could take a fight.
This is
going
to be a hard purge
well,
right
though.
Here. Come
really
on, baby.
And that's why Slark's in the game, man. That's the strength of him.
What?
Hard purge. Dark Pact.
What?
That's a real thing, dude. A soft purge is you can remove a disable that is weak, like Urn. You can purge that off. You can remove things like Thunderstrike.
Oh shit! FN is in some major trouble here. He is gonna pop a BKB though. I mean, that could have been the end of him. Bone 7 gonna be popping that out. Gem a True Sight up on Slark, so they do have a chance here. If they
whereas
can get some
a,
nice
a hard purge is a spell like Dark Pact, Abaddon, Shield.
Nobody cares how soft or hard
they,
you are,
they,
Purge.
They exist. Those things exist, dude.
I know we exist.
It's a real thing. I'm not just when saying it because I want to say it.
In 30 years, it's all going to be soft purge. Trust me. All right?
30, come on, more like 60 minimum.
60?
At that point, Icehawk will have removed.
Oh my god. What are we talking about anymore? Anyway.
Mechanics.
Mechanics. I'm not good at that. I don't know. I just feel bad. I don't see how Kaipe come back into this. I honestly don't. I mean, they have to not get chronoed. They have to get a pick off. They have to hope to God that they can stay together, grouped up enough to save each other from getting picked by Klinks, but not too grouped to be caught in the chrono. I mean, yeah, they gotta thread the needle here.
The problem was that they didn't exploit this pre-BKB timing well enough. They tried to take those fights, and the ones that they did take went a little south. And because of that, they didn't accelerate into the mid to late game. It was really just the mid game went okay, but not good enough to justify their hero picks. Because now Tidehunter just dies to 5 hits from Klinks. Normally tanky heroes that are survivable and difficult kill, Klinks makes them look like a joke.
Yep.
Just like.
And okay, they burnt. Anyway, down at the bottom, we're going to see a push here. I don't imagine that they would want to be through this. We have all the ultimates are up and ready to party. Most of the team has to TP back now, and if Void can just get anything resembling a decent chrono, this is going to be one easy fight for them. It is up to Team Kaipe to use their intelligence, their positioning, and their Dota knowledge to make sure that they get those hard purges.
All they have to do is play well, and it'll happen.
And then they fucking leave. Thanks a lot, Vega. All right, I set you up.
It was a good try.
Epic. God damn it.
Good effort setting up the fight.
Oh.
I think Tiny's going BKB, maybe. It's kind of a hard choice. You have to deal with Black King Bar to stop some of the magic spells or disables coming out of Vega. There's not that many, I guess, and most of them go right through magic immunity. So I think they need something like an AC Vlad's is the only way that they get back in this game a bit, because all of their heroes are just so vulnerable to the physical damage output of
I'm just a lowly 5k player. Why did they be? They have the damage.
You're not
they have
5K,
everything
you're,
they need.
You're rounding up. You're 4.7.
I'm 4.9.
Are you?
Okay. Yes.
Still rounding up. Scum.
Why
I'm not
did
a 6k
be?
Player. I'm
they
a 5.8k player.
Okay, shut up. Why did they be? They have everything they need. They're just letting Team Kaipe farm.
I think in that situation when you're going high ground, it just gets a little dangerous because once you go up the ramp, you're grouped already. So things like Disruptor Ulti become more effective. It gives your opponents more opportunities to initiate on you than the opposite. And if Kaipe buys back, then they could easily win the fight because then they teleport to the tower. They're already back in the fight. It's the defender's advantage, basically. So Vega's been consistently winning fights in open ground where Klinks can play around a lot of space. If he's trying to go high ground and get kills, the tower's always there for true sight. There's just so many things that make it difficult to go high ground, and if Vega's this far ahead, wait for the fights on the open ground. Basically like playing horses versus castles or something. You always want to fight with the horses on the ground, right?
What the not fuck the castles. Are you talking about?
What are horses going to do to siege it? What are they going to do to siege? All right, so you got one army that has a ton of horses, and you got one army that's...
What is this a reference to? I've never heard this in my life.
Legit battle?
Legit
we're theorycrafting battle.
You
got a bunch of horses,
and you're fighting.
Exactly, that's what I'm trying to say. That's what they would have been... Bring them out in the open. Run them in circles. I haven't you ever seen Lord of the Rings, dude? Jesus.
I'm not a nerd, all right? All I know is lore. I read the wiki of Lord of the Rings. I've never seen the movie, but I can tell you all about the lore. All right, well, let's see if these horses can bump up against this castle here. And,
they will be able to if nobody's actually standing inside of it, but Disruptor's going to show up.
Oh, well, they the scan reveals they scanned. Phone 7.
They scanned another. They know they're spread because they were very segmented.
Yes, it was quite a long scan. And the scan with
here.
The plan, they do catch him.
So
throw the arrow!
What?
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 What? What? That's why the icebergs are melting. Because they don't give a shit. Global warming is real. His brain just melted. What the hell was that, Purge?
I don't know, man. He attacked him twice and then chose to walk in and throw the arrow. It was a bit weird. He had vision from Shiva's too, so I don't know. Maybe he just didn't see the animation. I have no idea. Maybe he's still on cooldown. It's a possibility that his arrow didn't come off cooldown. I didn't have him selected.
I did.
Till last. He didn't have it for sure. Okay.
He had it.
Or he did have it for sure. Okay.
Guys,
BKB is the choice on Tiny. AC afterwards, perhaps, would be a good choice. Ghost Scepter on Disruptor, good choice, but there's a Diffusal Blade on Void, so that's already kind of offset. In some ways, it might have been better to go Vlad's.
Vlad's?
Four armor to everybody. It actually makes a huge difference.
Oh, okay.
and damage increase. Slark's hitting for 117 base, so Vlad's would give him like, I don't know, 18 damage. And as he steals more essence chip, that would also mean Vlad's does more and more action.
I'll see.
Things like that can make a huge difference. It offsets his Deso alone almost.
Looks like these horses are going to pony up here on Roshan as they put in all that damage that they can trying to get that Aegis. And they will be able to...
too.
Ooh, a butterfly. But meanwhile, a Self-Curious is going to come out on the Slarky Malarky.
Interesting on him instead of the Tiny, but Tiny's farm has had a little bit of trouble. And he's been more of an in-and-out sort of carry. Jump in, nuke, escape, repeat, do that multiple times, where Slark is always in the battle right-clicking. If you put an AC on Tiny, that aura might not be there offensively when it needs to be, so it kind of makes sense. You could even justify a Lotus Orb, maybe, after the plate mail, just so that he can debuff some spells on himself or reflect something good.
Uh-oh.
Like... Alright, there's literally no skills to reflect.
Ooh. Well, what are you gonna do?
You can remove time dilation from himself, that's actually clutch, but you can do that with BKB too.
True that, but who wants to use a BKB charge on that? Nobody. Yeah. Nobody. Oh, Blink Dagger coming up. That's pretty good on the Shadow Demon.
Time mobility to counter Clinks as well as the Void.
Yeah, this is why you should have pushed 9 minutes ago, boys, and not let him get all these awesome items. But what do I know? Here we go. Pylai in some trouble. He going to... Oh!
Ooh,
no
clutch
nap
save.
Time for me.
Oh, the Bambo's Force.
Woo! Very good.
If he got stomped there, he's definitely dead. 100%.
Very good analysis. Thank
and
you.
Then it would have been a 5v4, which is...
Whoa! You're blowing my brain!
Which means I have a much higher chance of taking...
Alright, here we go. Horses are
winning
moving up.
Horse game.
Will these horses... Oh my god, that is a perfect chrono on just the one that they need. You gotta get 3-3. Here we go, the damage coming out. No Ravage, no problem, and no way that they're gonna be able to win this team fight now. Sing Sing going down massively. There's the Ravage with the buyback. Good buyback. They're putting all of that they can on FN, but he is not giving a hoot, and he's gonna go down, though.
That's
the Bone 7 who comes in.
Oh, another Sing Sing can stay alive. This is huge.
Come on, Sing it, digging! 3-3 looking not so good, and he's out as well. There goes the Aegis, but Bone 7 is still alive. Can they put up enough gusto to get this Slarky Malarky down in prison yet again? Here we go, Dark Reef! Yes, hello again. Sing Sing bought back, but he's not looking too hot. Could he escape? No! He's out of there.
That's
and
easily
IP,
game.
A GG.
We're going to game 5 again. The last two series have been insane, but... $13,000 on the line, and Vega's pulling it out. Beautiful draft from them. Clinks did so much that game. It's fun to see FN use it. He barely died, and that always kept his advantage of minus armor, single target damage, and BKB at the perfect timings that allowed them to exploit the Kaipe lineup. So maybe Kaipe needed to force way more engagements early, but it just did.